Everybody, and you're listening to UZA's Miscreations podcast. So today, I want to talk about lighting and how important lighting is in your haunted attraction. So when you have objects or sets or scenes or characters, you want to make sure that they have the correct lighting and the correct mood and atmosphere you're going for. So when it comes to lighting, LED is probably your smartest way to go. There is all kinds of lights out there, tons and tons of different kinds of lights. I found that on Amazon they have some really affordable lights that are LED. They're 10 watt, which is perfect because it's not too bright, it's not too dim, and also these lights you can change the colors as well as how intense. And if you want to decrease the intensity of the light. So these lights work really good. They're little squares. They're easy to hide. And they can either be hung up or placed on the ground. So they're really good lights. There's another option. You can get theater lights or the little round ones. Those ones are good as well. Again, you can change the colors, the intensity, all that. And they also can be hung up or can be on the ground or whatever you want. But what about, like, different kinds of lighting? Like, if you want to, I don't know, just step up your haunt a little bit more to the next level. Well, you have your lasers, you have your strobes, you have all that stuff. So you have all these different kinds of options of how to light your haunt or what to do or what color. And really, it's basic color theory. You know, you have your warm colors, you have your cool colors, you have your secondary, you have your tertiary, you have your primary. There's so many different things. And if you don't know anything about basic color theory or any of that, research it, look it up. Color theory is one thing that everybody should learn because it's not just used in lighting, it's used in art and all kinds of stuff, makeup. The color wheel is your best friend. So when you're doing lights, what mood do you want them to feel? And you can research different moods and stuff based on colors. So, like, if you're maybe wanting them to feel rushed or like something's gonna happen, red's a really good light. Red is kind of a rushed feeling. That's why, like, McDonald's restaurants a long time ago used to use red and yellow because that gets you out. You know, do you want to use blue? Do you want to use green? It just depends on what you're trying to say. Like, if you're doing a swamp, green lights would be good with maybe blue. Or if you're doing, like, infernal fire, red is a great color. Red and orange and even yellow and maybe a little bit of blue. So you can mix colors as well as just have one solid color. It also depends on what you're doing. Are you doing a holiday themed? Like, my haunt does different holiday themes. So when we do different ones, I change the lighting up. So, for instance, Easter would be pinks and purples, yellows and blues. Valentine's Day would be red, white, and pink, and sometimes purple. And then you have, like, Halloween, orange, black, green, purple. You know, so you have different things or different reasons to change your lighting, which also makes your haunt different every time they go through if you have something different. Talking about that, Froggy Fog has invented a swamp, a laser swamp, which is amazing and probably one of my favorite parts because I love lights, and the swamp is such a cool effect. It's lasers and it looks as if you're walking in water, but it's lasers and it's a fog trick. If you don't know what I'm talking about, look it up, Froggy Fog's swamp. It is amazing. They do great things. I love Froggy Fog. You can buy the swamp. I think the cheapest one's like $600. It's a home one. And it's basic, but it's good and it's a good start. It's good to get it and mess around with. Now the swamp, you can do all kinds of things with that. And you can put green with it. But what I started doing was with the swamp lasers, I actually added another laser, which is more of like a laser show. So it plays off and it kind of looks cool because it's on, you know, it's on the swamp and you see all these lights and stuff. It's a really cool effect, but you can, you know, play and do different things with lighting. Lighting is super, super important because if you have terrible lighting, they won't be able to see what you're wanting to show them. The actors won't be seen, or maybe they're too overseen. So you want to be careful and you want to walk through your haunt and make sure the lighting is what you want and that what is needing to be seen is seen. If you need hiding spots, maybe less light, you know, or you have a really cool actor that has really detailed makeup, make sure that they have light that they can see that and it's not, you know, you can't be seen. It's kind of the same with theater lighting as well. You know, you want to over exaggerate on some things and take it back a little. And with makeup in the dark, you know, also with your makeup, look at it and see, am I too light with the makeup that they can't see it? Or do I need to be heavier because they are in a darker area and I need to over exaggerate? You know, is it better just to go with a mask in this area? These are all things that are important with lighting. Strobes are a great thing. You can do cool effects with them if you know how to work them and do them right. Strobes are not, yes, I repeat, strobes are not lighting. Do not do your whole entire haunt in strobe lights. First of all, it's unsafe. And also, what if you have an actor or actress that cannot be around that? Not to mention, there are many customers that cannot go through with strobe. And maybe one or two they can manage, but if you do your whole entire haunt in strobe lights and you don't even have safety lights, that is a problem. You do not want to just rely, because I know they're cheap, you can get them at Walmart, the little ones or whatever, but no, you don't. It takes away from your haunt because it's not cool. Don't do just strobes. I've seen people do it. It just doesn't work. Please don't. And even if you have a yard haunt, don't just use strobes to light up your scenes. Switch it up. Have some solid lights. Have some different colored lights. Don't rely just on strobe lights. I can't stress that enough. It's not a good idea. I mean, you can do what you want. It's your haunt, but you want to switch it up. You want people to be able to go through and see things. Don't want to miss out on having those customers or those potential, you know, people to walk through because you have so many strobe lights. When we do strobe, I do maybe a little bit, but I don't just do my whole haunt in strobe, and I don't do that many. And when I do strobe, it has to have a reason behind it. And when we do use it, we use it in a long hallway with stuff hanging down, and the actor can like hide in and out and stuff, or a really slow motion so it looks creepy when they see you in that long hallway. That's a good idea, but just doing your whole haunt in strobes, do not do that.